happy or you want. Along with that, you can be playing quarters with the hi-hat. So. This is a little bit trickier because the coordination, but ultimately what you want to be doing is listening for the sound of your voices on the instrument. When you stop and think about it, wait a minute, can I do five things at once? Right. Especially if you're a singing drummer, which is, you know, Don Henley or Phil Collins or these guys, they're singing and they're playing, so it's like, whoa, how do you even think to manage that? Typically, the flam as a usable sound would be one, two, three. You'd be using it as a. So there's a slight delay between the two notes. So it kind of can say like a plop. I don't know if you guys have terminology you like to use for the flams. But versus like. Which is kind of unison sticking, both hands playing the same notes at the same volume. Last example is to use this song. You're going along as one, two, three, four, one, two, three, and four. Maybe if it's just as simple as that.
Yeah.
One, two, three, four, one, two. So I might play a fill that's like one, two, and, ba bum. You know, one, two, and three, and four, and one would be how you would count it.
Okay.
Or it might just be a little pickup, which is, you know, one, two, three, four. And four,
right.
Ba ba, and it just gives, it's a marker for the part of the song.
Okay.
So yeah, definitely get used to counting them when you're first starting and know what beat you're going to start on. Relax, breathe, because oftentimes it's that moment of truth, oh my God, I'm going to play a fill. And chances are, if you're not super confident, and maybe work out the sticking ahead of time if you're going to be, you know, leading with your right. Yeah, yeah, so he's using that all day long. And a lot of it is kind of paradiddle based, rudimental based stuff. I'm going to talk about that in a second down near the bottom with using rudiments that are friendly to use on the drum set.